Dr. Kornbluth, at MIT, does calling for the genocide of Jews violate MIT's code of conduct or rules regarding bullying and harassment? Yes or no?
If targeted at individuals, not making public statements.
Yes or no? Calling for the genocide of Jews does not constitute bullying and harassment?
I have not heard calling for the genocide for Jews on our campus.
But you've heard chants for Intifada.
I've heard chants, which can be anti-Semitic depending on the context, when calling for the elimination of the Jewish people.
So those would not be according to the MIT's code of conduct or rules?
That would be investigated as harassment if pervasive and severe.
Ms. McGill, at Penn, does calling for the genocide of Jews violate Penn's rules or code of conduct? Yes or no?
If the speech turns into conduct, it can be harassment, yes.
I am asking, specifically calling for the genocide of Jews, does that constitute bullying or harassment?
If it is directed and severe or pervasive, it is harassment.
So the answer is yes.
It is a context-dependent decision, Congresswoman.
It's a context-dependent decision. That's your testimony today. Calling for the genocide of Jews is depending upon the context. That is not bullying or harassment. This is the easiest question to answer yes, Ms. McGill. So is your testimony that you will not answer yes?
If the speech becomes conduct, it can be harassment, yes.
Conduct meaning committing the act of genocide? The speech is not harassment? This is unacceptable, Ms. McGill. I'm gonna give you one more opportunity for the world to see your answer. Does calling for the genocide of Jews violate Penn's code of conduct when it comes to bullying and harassment? Yes or no?
It can be harassment.
The answer is yes. And Dr. Gay, at Harvard, does calling for the genocide of Jews violate Harvard's rules of bullying and harassment? Yes or no?
It can be, depending on the context.
What's the context?
Targeted at an individual.
It's targeted at Jewish students, Jewish individuals. Do you understand your testimony is dehumanizing them? Do you understand that dehumanization is part of antisemitism? I will ask you one more time. Does calling for the genocide of Jews violate Harvard's rules of bullying and harassment? Yes or no?
Anti-Semitic rhetoric.
And is it anti-Semitic rhetoric?
Anti-Semitic rhetoric when it crosses into conduct that amounts to bullying, harassment, intimidation, that is actionable conduct and we do take action.
So the answer is yes. That calling for the genocide of Jews violates Harvard code of conduct, correct?
Again, it depends on the context.
It does not depend on the context. The answer is yes, and this is why you should resign. These are unacceptable answers across the board.